Hi everyone, it's Janis here with a new episode to help you build better daily structure and be in control of your life. You're given 2 weeks to complete the project at work. You got plenty of time, but you don't want to leave it till the last minute, so you think that you should get the ball rolling. A week goes by, but you haven't even started. It's in the back of your mind, but the pressure is not strong enough for you to take action. 2 days left. Oh my God, how am I gonna get this done? You put all your focus and energy into the project and you submit it just before the deadline. If this sounds familiar and you occasionally or often leave the things till the last minute, then you should know that it is a Parkinson's law. Today, we'll take a look at what Parkinson's law is, how it works, and how you can take advantage of it. If this is your first time on this channel, then make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon to get updates on my latest videos on time management and productivity. Also consider joining my free productivity mastermind group, where I do live coaching calls and live Q&As, where you have a chance to ask me any questions. Parkinson's law states work expands so as to fill the time available for its completion. So let me give you a few examples to actually illustrate it. If you have 1 hour to tidy up your room, then you're likely to spend 1 hour doing it. But if you only have half an hour, then you're likely to do it in half an hour. If you have 4 hours to write an essay, then that's how much time you will spend on it. Whereas if you only had 2.5 hours available, then you would still get it done. In both of these cases, it's not likely that the quality of the work would be much different even when the available time is considerably reduced. We can't change Parkinson's law, but what we can do is we can use it in a way that makes us more productive. So let's take a look at some of the pointers and strategies on how we can use it in our favor and take advantage of it. Number 1, Parkinson's law and time blocking. I have been using time blocking for a few years now, and I'm sometimes wonder why I'm almost always able to complete all my planned activities during my time blocks. I keep time blocks for almost all my activities, writing scripts, voicing them, doing strategic planning and decision making. And it turns out that time blocking and Parkinson's law is built on the same principles. Time blocking is a time management approach that requires to allocate a time block for each individual activity, and Parkinson's law states work expands so as to fill the time available for its completion. And here is the answer to my question of why I almost always complete my activities that I allocate time blocks for. Of course, the key here is to make sure that we allocate the minimum time required to complete the task to get most out of our time blocking. I know I was struggling with the creative tasks at the beginning, but with time, you'll be able to accurately predict the time necessary for tasks completion. Therefore, if you want to increase your productivity, then you should definitely plan your time and structure your weekly schedule using a time blocking approach. Number 2, set deadlines. One mistake that many people make is that they don't set deadlines for their goals and projects, and then they wonder why they can't complete them. If you don't have a deadline for your project, then you'll keep adding more and more things to it and never actually complete it. When I was developing my mobile application, I made the same mistake of not setting a deadline. The result was development that lasted 3 years for the project that should have been completed in 1 year. You might be working on your new website, writing your own book or any other project, and if you don't have a clear deadline, it will take 3 times longer to complete it. So take a look at your current projects and make sure that you have clear deadlines set for each of them to make sure that you don't waste any time. Number 3, keep actionable tasks. One thing that is often keeping people back from getting things done and moving forward is the fact that they have a broad tasks. This is what stops people to set deadlines and instead makes them procrastinate because it's not clear when the task will be completed. Things like developing an app, getting more leads, or working on a website are impossible to measure and you will not be able to estimate their completion and therefore spend more time than needed. The solution here is simple. You must ensure that your daily activities are measurable so that you can actually get them completed. When you have a clear activity or task, you can estimate how much time it will take to complete it. This will enable you to set a deadline and take advantage of Parkinson's law. Number 4, Parkinson's law in other areas of life. If you think about it, Parkinson's law doesn't only apply to time, but it also applies to other aspects of our life. If you have $1,000 budget for your new computer, then that's what you probably spend on it. But if you only have $300, then you will still get a computer. Same goes for knowledge. You don't have to be the smartest person in the room in order to pass the test. You simply need to know enough about a certain topic. Number 5, commitment and Parkinson's law. When you make a decision to get something in your life, then you will almost always find a way how to arrive at your desired destination. When you want to pass the test, you study hard and pass it. When you want to get in a good shape, you improve your diet, start to exercise, and soon after that, you'll be in a good physical shape. The key ingredient is initial commitment that you are making. In these particular examples, it was a commitment to pass the test and a commitment to get in shape. With the Parkinson's law, it's the same. You make a commitment that you'll complete a certain task or project in a set time frame, and then you put in the energy required to get it accomplished. I hope that you enjoyed this video and it gave you clear understanding about what Parkinson's law is and how to use it in your life. If you enjoyed this video, then make sure you hit that like button. And if you're new to this channel, then type new in the comments below. If you want to learn how to set better goals, make better decisions, and build solid structure in your life, then check out my free Productivity Mastermind course to take your productivity to the next level. Also, be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss my upcoming videos.